after William Devon and Curtis Mayfield. Though you may not drive a great big Cadillac.
Janae Johnson, who actually founded the House Slam in Boston, which is a really awesome poetry space, had a really great idea, like, what if we did a space like that in the Bay?
I watched her fly, and I loved the way her wings were blowing.
She really wanted to start a venue that was founded in Mission and also kind of an alternative space, just knowing that a lot of folks in the Bay weren't quite getting to mics and getting to stages, so we wanted to create a more accessible space for everyone.
I am one of the co-founders and core organizers of the Root Slam, along with Janae Johnson, Teresa Siangatonu, Natasha Huey, Gabriel Cortez, and Jay Cho. I think of the Root Slam and the collective of us who are coming together to create an intentional space. We're all poets, we're all teaching artists, we're all organizers, we're all educators. It was really important for us to come together and create spaces that we wanted to see in the world that reflect the communities that we grew up in and that we love, especially in this age of gentrification in Oakland. The Oakland that I grew up in looks very different today.
I pull up to the park and I climb the rope at Venice Beach to the sky like he said I would. My daddy whistles and
we have our open mic, which is wide open to poems, to raps, to music by amazing vocalists. On the open mics, that's usually the first portion of the show. We might have a featured poet in the middle, who's usually a touring, nationally acclaimed poet who we all look up to. And then we also have the slam portion after, which is a competitive event. And the winner of each slam wins both a gift card to Marcus Books, which is right up the street from MLK Cafe, and then also a free meal at MLK Cafe.
Part of our mission is really to center the voices of historically marginalized communities and specific to Oakland. So try to make an open mic and a slam that centers the voices of Black, people of color, queer, trans folks, working class folks, immigrant, migrant folks, gender nonconforming and non-binary folks too. I think that we do our best to try to center those folks on the mic by giving them priority on the microphone.
One of the things that interests me most about the Root Slam is I do a lot of work with Youth Speaks, which is like a 22-year-old organization, was a huge point of entry for how I got involved with spoken word poetry. And now as a staff member, I recognize that there aren't a lot of spaces once folks age out that feel like it's in continuum with the values that and the pedagogy and the culture that we're trying to create in that space. So I was really interested in having a place that felt like my home that I can invite my students to once they graduate.
The workshops happen here at Chapter 510. We'll have some kind of check-in or icebreaker and then 1 to 2 generative writing activities. Part of the mission of the Root Slam is to really create a space for the artistic growth of the Bay Area community.
The Alternative Exposure Grant funds our Ekphrastic series. Basically, we're able to hire and work with and collaborate visual artists.
We could have local artists intentionally make art in response to some of the awesome poets that we're bringing in from around the country. The exciting things about having a consistent space that we're in MLK Cafe, that's been super open and flexible to not just letting us fill the space with our voices, but also putting some art on the wall.
I came together to be part of a collective of some of my closest friends and organizers who wanted to make a space that was free, that was accessible to folks in Oakland, and that centered voices that reflect our communities and our family.
Diamond in the back, sun rooftop, digging in the scene with the gangster lean.